Hello viewers and learners, welcome to the present module on utilization of digital tools and techniques. With today's greeting, I am Professor Naseeb Singh Gill, Department of Computer Science and Applications and Director, Digital Learning Initiatives and Monitoring Cell of Maharshi Dayanand University, Rohtak, Haryana. Educational research confirms the vital significance of digital tools and technology as an emblem for efficient and scholastic attainments in the 21st century and has become the witness of increased 4C skills. 4C means in the form of communication, creativity, critical thinking, and collaboration. The best learning happens when real-world contexts are combined to solve problems. Digital tools are changing essential features of the pedagogical context at fast speed. This module on utilization of digital tools and techniques highlights the conceptual and practical understanding of digital tools, how these tools are affecting teaching and learning, which digital tools are useful, and how to implement these tools in an effective manner. So first of all, let's outline the learning objectives of the present modules. By the end of the present module, learners will be able to understand, number one, digital tools and their emergence. Number two, digital learning environment related terminologies. Number three, difference between synchronous and asynchronous communication. Number four, role of digital tools in effective classroom instructions. And number five, types of digital tools and their relevance in effective classroom instruction. We expect that by the end of this module, learners would be able to understand these concepts, which would further help and enrich the learners in more pedagogical innovations. So first of all, let's learn about digital tools and its emergence. Digital learning environment is emerging at fast pace in 21st century. Learners are turning into digital natives. Therefore, their learning environment needs to be equipped with relevant digital tools and techniques to fulfill their learning needs. Utilization of digital tools in educational environment improves the knowledge, skills, and information in a wonderful manner. In this digital age, it is crucial and requisite to integrate pedagogy or teaching learning process with technology for making classrooms more interesting, motivating, and inspiring. Teachers and students may utilize digital learning resources in miscellaneous ways to make teaching and learning process more vibrant, sustained, and vigorous. In 21st century, there is major replacement of learning modes in the form of switching traditional learning from digital learning based on digital learning tools and technologies. So now, this is the time to forget old teaching and learning methods of traditional age. We may witness the inclusion of digital context in classrooms from different perspectives. It may vary from using smart digital board, tablets, software tools, other hardware equipments, and overall enjoying smart classrooms. It could further be elaborated by utilizing internet facilities, teaching tools, and methodologies. Digital tools empower, inspire, motivate, and encourage students by getting them exposure in learning and expanding their horizons. Now let's learn about the terminology and jargons related to digital tools and digital learning environment. So first, let's understand what are digital tools. Digital tools are the online or offline tools, applications, service apps, games that can be utilized to enhance pedagogical decisions and educational experiences. Next in the sequence is digital devices. Digital devices are nothing but computers, laptops, iPads, PDAs, mobiles, tablets, and so many more gadgets. Next in the sequence is digital technology. Digital technology may be described as applications, services, and resources utilized in exploring, analyzing, creating, and communicating data and information in digital context. Next is the very fantastic term and very popular term, digital classroom. The digital classroom is widely acknowledged as technology empowered classroom, where teaching and learning activities are completely supported through digital tools and technologies. Digital classrooms are also known as flipped classrooms or smart classrooms. Next, very popular another term is digital native. Digital native is nothing but a person who was born with the extensive espousal of digital technology. This term is not particularly related to generation, but is concerned with such individuals who have grown up with using mobiles, internet, computers, laptops, or other electronic gadgets. So next in the sequence, let's understand the synchronous and asynchronous communication and how these two are different. Let's understand first what is synchronous communication. Synchronous actions and happenings are time-bound. In synchronous communication, this is necessary condition that both parties remain present at that time when communicating. Examples of synchronous communication include chat and instant messaging, video and audio conferences, live webcasting, application sharing, whiteboard interaction, polling, and so many others. Similarly, if we have a look at asynchronous communication, asynchronous events are time independent. Examples of asynchronous includes email, discussion forums, wikis, blogs, webcasting, and so many others. So now let's learn about benefits of these tools and how the digital tools have contributed significantly in making the classroom learning very effective. Digital tools play a very significant role in effective classroom instructions, which is quite essential for the digital learners of 21st century. It mainly includes the main roles, such as number one, it makes learning more interesting and funny. Learning generation of 21st century is digital native in nature. Students enjoy technology in their classroom learning. It makes learning more interesting and funny. In fact, educational experiences become more interesting with digital learning, and digital learning makes students smarter. They would be able to generate e-contents, and technology increases self-directed learning among students and learners. Number two, it prepares students for the digital future. using technology in the classroom would help to prepare students for the digital future. Research has revealed that technology helps them retain information better. Technology enables students to learn at their own pace as well as place. Digital learning is making students self-motivated and more accountable. Number three, it develops skills essential for the 21st century. When utilizing technology in the classroom, both teachers and students can develop skills which are essential qualities for the 21st century. Students can learn useful digital skills, media skills, information skills, and life skills through these digital tools and technology. Through internet, we may explore and enhance our skills like collaboration, participation, and production among stakeholders. Number four, technology can help improve teaching. There are numerous resources on web where teachers and students might be benefited and can have excellent literature regarding their educational and pedagogical context. Teachers can use different apps or trusted online resources and may enjoy virtual lessons plans, presentation tools, and assessment tools for making teaching more meaningful and enjoyable with safe and secure databases. Number four, documentation and digital repository. Through technology, we may preserve educational data in the form of text, assessments, grades, recorded lectures, and so on. Number six, it may also play other roles. Technology can make static lessons more dynamic. It promotes self-directed learning. It encourages collaboration and supports differentiated instruction. Technology empowers and encourages students for expertise in collaboration, communication, and participation. So now let's step forward and learn about the types and varieties of digital tools used for creating such a vibrant and digitally transformed learning environment. There are several types of digital tools that can be used in effective classroom instruction. Such popular digital tools may be classified in primarily seven categories, which include: number one, online collaboration and communication tools; number two, content creation tools; number three, presentation software tools; number four, concept mapping and mind mapping tools; number five, drill and practice tools; number six, lecture capture tools; number seven, course management system tools. Now let's understand these tools one by one. Number one, online collaboration and communication tool. This is a term used for different types of software, mobile apps, and online services that allow people to communicate and collaborate regardless of their physical location in real time over the internet. Examples of such tools include like Gmail, Google Drive, Google Scholar, ResearchGate, Skype, video conferencing, social media, and several more. Now let's move to number second category of these tools, and that is content creation tools. Content creation is the generation of contents to digital media for general and specific context expressed in the form of text, images, or any form for purposeful activity prepared by individuals. Examples of content creation tools include maintaining and updating websites, blogging, photography, videography, social media accounts, and so many more. Third category of such tools are presentation software tools. A presentation program is nothing but a software package used to display information in the form of a slideshow. Basically, it has three functions. Number one, content or text in main points to be inserted and formatted. Number two, inserting and manipulating graphic images with animation. Number three, slideshow system to display the contents and graphics. Examples of presentation software tools include PowerPoint slides, Presentation Tube, Google Slides, Prezi, SlideDoc, Windows Movie Maker, and Academic Presenter. Fourth category of these tools are concept mapping and mind mapping tools. A mind map or concept map is nothing but a graphical way to symbolize or generate information, ideas, and concepts. It may be defined as a visual thinking tool to organize information, ideas, and concept in a superior mode for analysis, synthesis, comprehension, recalling, and generation. Although both are not similar in characteristics, but share some purpose and objectives. Mind map has a radial structure and focus on one concept, whereas concept map emphasizes on multiple concepts or ideas having characteristics of tree structure with branches and clusters. Examples of such tools include Kaggle, Mindomo. Fifth category of such tools include drill and practice tools. Drill and practice tools are apps and application software that provides extensive practice in the form of exercises in which learners can do more practice at their own speed and receive proper feedback on their responses. These tools are based on philosophy of knowledge acquisition or skills through repetitive practice, memorization of spelling or vocabulary words, practicing of arithmetic facts or science equations may be efficiently practiced through these tools. Although these activities are considered small tasks, but these are basic or fundamental elements of any subject. Good drill and practice software provides feedback to students, explains how to get correct answer, and contains a management system to keep track of students' progress. Examples of such tools include instructional software, Flashcards Plus. Sixth category of tools are lecture capture tools. Lecture capture is nothing but the process of recording audio and video contents and making it available in digital format for students to view online. Therefore, lecture capture may be defined as the process of recording a lecture that will be placed on the web for students to watch online. This process is completed with different lecture capture tools. Some popular lecture capture tools include such as MediaSite, Zoom, VideoNote, QuickTime, Catania Studio, MediaSpace, Zinc, Screencast-O-Matic, and so many others. Now, seventh category of such tools are course management system tools. A course management system may be defined as a set of tools. A course management system may be defined as a set of tools that supports the instructor or teacher to generate online course contents and post it on the web without knowing programming languages. A course management system is a collection of software tools providing an online environment for course interactions. The use of technology such as webinars, podcasts, videocasts, and other online learning objects can be very effective in imparting such concepts. Examples of course management systems include such as Moodle, Blackboard Learn, Google Classroom, and so many others. Apart from these seven types of tools, there is also another category which is also widely known among learners and researchers, and that is electronic resources. So now let's learn about electronic resources. Electronic resources are also known as educational resource material, which is created in a digital format and available electronically. Examples of electronic resources include websites, electronic journals, and electronic and online databases in digital setups. There are some popular electronic resources such as SciFinder, Scopus, Web of Science, and Google Scholar. From these online databases, scholars can search information around the world, and these electronic resources provide learners an extensive search of scholarly literature in the form of books, abstracts, articles, and research papers. In subsequent modules, we will further explore these tools in detail. So now let's sum up the present module. Digital tools and technology have become the witness of increased force skills in the form of communication, creativity, critical thinking, and collaboration. In order to sustain these skills, digital tools are playing a pivotal role in the pedagogical designs and innovations. There are different types of relevant and stable digital tools that can be used in effective classroom instructions in 21st century. I hope that you would have enjoyed the current module, and we will soon join you with another module on pedagogical innovations and research methodology. Thank you very much for enjoying as well as for your active participation in this module.